Non-ionizing radiation is particles that do not have enough energy to remove a bound electron from an atom or molecule in an interaction, such as a collision, but may have enough energy to move electrons upward in orbitals of an atom. Let's take a look at both ionizing radiation and non-ionizing radiation. The case on the left is ionizing radiation. The case on the right is non-ionizing radiation. In the case on the left of ionizing radiation, we have a particle that's coming in, which in this case is a photon, and that particle has enough energy to ionize this electron or remove the electron from the bound atom. After the interaction, we are left with a hydrogen ion, which is just a proton, and a free electron. The electron has energy. It travels in its own path and it's in its own direction. In the case on the right, we have non-ionizing radiation. Non-ionizing radiation are particles that do not have enough energy to remove a bound electron from an atom or molecule. Here we're looking at a photon or another particle that is coming in to an atom. The particle strikes or interacts with the electron, and if the energy of the incoming photon or particle is enough of the right amount, then the electron will move upwards in an orbital. After a short period of time, the electron will cascade back down in orbital, releasing a photon. Non-ionizing radiation does involve some radiation coming from the system, or it may involve no radiation coming from the system, because the incoming photon or particle has to have just the right amount of energy to cause the electron to move up in an orbital. If it doesn't have the correct amount of energy, the electron will just stay where it is and the photon will just pass through the atom. So non-ionizing radiation does involve some radiation. The radiation that it does involve is photons of energy that is less than in the ionizing case.